This video will demonstrate how to use the ThinkReality portal to manage device settings, organize devices into groups, and change the software update policy for your organization. Some of the settings that can be changed in the settings menu on each device can also be changed using the ThinkReality portal. Open the Devices section of the ThinkReality portal. Select the device you want to manage from the list to open a slide-out menu for the device on the right side of the screen. Modify the device settings you wish to edit and click the Save button on the bottom of the device menu to apply the changes. Device settings that can be changed using the portal include device name, blue light filter, USB file transfer, controller handedness, system language, and time zone. Edit the device name at the top of the device slide-out menu. The device name appears on the home screen of the headset in LAN-School Air. Blue light filter is the same as the eye protection mode setting found in the settings menu of the Lenovo Mirage VRS3 headset. This setting helps prevent eye strain by filtering out blue light, but is turned off by default. The USB file transfer settings determine whether or not users can transfer files to or from the headset by USB. Controller handedness adjusts the calibration of the controller to be held in either the right or the left hand. The device system language is set to English by default. The Lenovo Mirage VRS3 headsets also support Spanish, French, Italian, German, Portuguese, Japanese, Korean, simplified Chinese, and traditional Chinese, but some content may not be available in all languages. Time zone settings allow you to use the time zone on the device or use the drop-down menu to specify a time zone for the device using the portal. Use the Device Group section of the Devices page to place devices into groups. Devices can only be part of one group at a time. Once a device has been placed into a group, it will no longer be shown under the Ungroup Devices tab. Select Create Group from the Grouping menu to create a new device group. Enter a name for the new group and optionally enter a description for the group, then click the Save button. Click on a group name in the group's list to edit it in a slide-out menu on the right side of the screen. You can change the name of the group, add devices, or delete the entire group by clicking the Delete button on the bottom. Click the Save button after making any desired changes. Click the triangle next to the group name to display all the devices that are part of that group. Toggle the checkboxes next to specific devices or the entire group to modify multiple devices at once. Select Manage Settings from the Management menu to change device settings for the selected devices. Click the Apply to All button when finished making changes. Select Group Device from the Grouping menu to add or remove selected devices to or from groups. Select devices on the left side of the window, choose a group on the right side, and click the Add button to add devices into a group. Select devices under a group name on the right side and click the Remove button to remove them from a group. Click the Save button when finished making changes.
Setting a device pin for your organization will prevent headset users from being able to factory reset a device or access the developer settings menu without knowing the pin. To set a pin protection policy for your organization, click your name in the top right of the screen and select Organization Settings. On the Pin Policy tab, toggle Pin Protection on. Click the Generate Pin button to create a randomly generated pin. Click the Apply Pin button to activate the pin protection on all devices. Lenovo occasionally releases software and system updates for Lenovo Mirage VRS3 devices to improve device security, fix bugs, and add new features. There are two different policies your organization can set for receiving system updates, automatic and manual. In the default automatic policy, all devices will automatically download and install system updates as soon as they become available. Active hours can be set that prevent devices from updating during specified times when the device may be in use. Updates will automatically download outside of active hours as long as the devices are powered on and connected to the internet during that time. Using the manual update policy means that devices will not automatically update when the system update becomes available. Updates will need to be manually initiated using the ThinkReality portal. To set a system update policy for your organization, click your name in the top right of the screen and select Organization Settings. Select the Device Updates tab. Use the drop-down menu to select the update policy you wish to use. If you select the Do Not Install During Active Hours checkbox, you will also need to set the active hours period, during which your devices will not update automatically. Select the Only Check for Updates on These Days checkbox to restrict updates to certain days of the week. Click the Confirm button to apply the changes. To manually update devices during active hours or when the policy is set to manual, go to the Device section of the ThinkReality portal.
Select the devices that you wish to update and click the Update Device option in the Management menu at the top of the Devices list.
This button is disabled unless an update is available. Individual devices can also be updated by clicking the Update button at the top of the Device slide-out menu.
The update policy also affects any updates made to the content that comes with VR Classroom 2. If your update policy is set to automatic, content updates will begin downloading on your devices automatically. If you use the active hour settings, the content will automatically deploy to devices outside of the set active hours, or it can be deployed manually during active hours. If your organization uses the manual update policy, you will be required to deploy content updates manually.
To manually deploy the VR Classroom content, open the recommended page under the content section. Select the checkboxes next to all the content you want to deploy, and then click the Deploy button at the top of the page. Select the devices you wish to deploy the content to in the pop-up box that appears. Review the summary to double-check your selections and click the Deploy button. You will be notified that the content has successfully deployed. For more information, watch our other videos about Lenovo VR Classroom 2 or visit support.lenovo.com/VRClassroom.